I greet you this day in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I welcome you to St. James's on this 23rd Sunday after Pentecost. Our service begins with the opening acclamation of Eucharistic Prayer Rite II. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be thy kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Blessed Lord, who caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, grant us so to hear them, read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that we may embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life, which you have given us in our Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Please be seated for readings from Holy Scripture.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. For I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. Former things shall not be remembered or come to mind. But be glad and rejoice forever in what I am creating. For I am about to create Jerusalem as a joy and its people as a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and delight in my people. No more shall the sound of weeping be heard in it or the cry of distress. No more shall there be in it an infant that lives but a few days or an old person who does not live out a lifetime. For one who dies at 100 years will be considered a youth, and one who falls short of 100 will be considered accursed. They shall build houses and inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards and eat their fruit. They shall not build and another inhabit. They shall not plant and another eat. For like the days of a tree shall the days of my people be, and my chosen shall long enjoy the work of their hands. They shall not labor in vain or bear children for calamity. They shall be offspring blessed by the Lord and their descendants as well. Before they call, I will answer. While they are yet speaking, I will hear. The wolf and the lamb shall feed together. The lion shall eat straw like the ox. But the serpent, its food shall be dust. It shall not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
When some were speaking about the temple, how it was adorned with beautiful stones and gifts dedicated to God, Jesus said, "As for these things that you see, the days will come when not one stone will be left upon another. All will be thrown down." They asked him, "Teacher, when will this be? And what will be the sign that this is about to take place?" And he said, "Beware that you are not led astray, for many will come in my name and say, 'I am he,' and 'the time is near.' Do not go after them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for these things must take place first, but the end will not follow immediately." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes, and in various places famines and plagues. And there will be dreadful portents and great signs from heaven. But before all this occurs, they will arrest you and persecute you. They will hand you over to synagogues and prisons, and you'll be brought before kings and governors because of my name. This will give you an opportunity to testify. So make up your minds not to prepare your defense in advance, for I will give you words and a wisdom that none of your opponents will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers, by relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair of your head will perish. By your endurance, you will gain your souls." The Gospel of our Lord.
I speak the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, thank God for Children's Chapel, because I was thinking, with all those kids up there, I'm going to have to toss out a couple pages. Now I don't. But let me get this right. You all just said, "Praise to thee, O Lord," after hearing that gospel lesson, right?
Yes.
So let's figure this. At the forum at 10 o'clock, which I encourage you all to attend, give your permission to skip my class, go to hear about the master plan, which hopefully become the master's plan. And while they're discussing what's going to happen to this lovely facility and all that, Jesus appears and says, "Not one stone will be left on stone. All will be destroyed." And you all say, "Praise to thee, O Lord." I don't think so. How many of you were here before the fire? Oh, yeah. And afterwards? And then you show, then you, when you have friends and family show up and you say, look at what we've done, all this, look at what has happened, isn't this lovely, isn't this beautiful? Was the aisle always had that slant to it, or is it just my bad knee that makes me feel like I can't sing and walk at the same time? So imagine, gone. Well, we have been through the Great Tribulation. It was called COVID. We couldn't attend church. For almost 2.5 years, if it weren't for Zoom and stuff like that, we were out. We couldn't break bread together. We were part of another church, but you were able to sign up and come in and spend 15 minutes and come up and receive communion and leave, but you, it was kind of like the early service where you sit all over the place and no one's going to touch anybody, and just you and Jesus all alone. And it wasn't the same. You know, Nancy and I got the Eucharist, but it wasn't the same. It wasn't the same as being able to gather together. And Jesus says, we're hearing this because we're nearing the end of the church year. Next Sunday will be the end of this year, and then we begin Advent. And we hear what's going to happen. A new thing, Isaiah says. God says, I'm creating a new thing, and no one will remember. Now, God, I don't know. God couldn't have said that. Because we do remember. I took my grandson years ago to the new Avenger movie. He's about 14. And it's the one where, I don't remember the title of it, but, you know, we get popcorn and we knock it off before the movie starts, and I go back and get another tub. And we sit there and munch. And halfway through the movie, the guy who's going to kill all the people in the world to be able to start off new again, and they're all saying, you can't do that. You can't kill off all the people. And he says, because I have to. Because as long as there's someone there who remembers what was, you'll never be able to move to what could be. Now, my next part of this is I have never heard anything like this about St. James's. Only in other congregations that I've served. It is our very nature to murmur. If you read Scripture, you know we murmur. We murmured constantly. The Israelites said, weren't there melons enough in Egypt that you bring us out here in the desert to die? And God gives us manna. And you know what manna stands for? Ever put anything in front of your kid? And they said, what's that? That's what manna means. What's that? Were we rejoicing in the wilderness? No. We ate the manna and we said, well, you know. So God sends quail. That's a great story. So for the clergy who went through COVID and trying to keep their congregations together, they tried all different new things, from Zoom to outdoor services to this to that, and the congregations all met with a great huzzah. Praise God. Thank you. Wonderful. Can't wait. God love you. And Isaiah says, the Lord is going to create a new thing. And the choir sang about, sing to the Lord a new song. We hate the word new. Why can't you ever sing my favorite hymn? Well, we did last Sunday. Well, I wasn't here. Well, the lady told me, I just can't worship in a wooden building. I had a church in Connecticut, wooden. It was gorgeous. It could only be in stone like Jesus had. And I said, well, Jesus never had a church. Well, if he did, it would have been stone. So we've been through this great tribulation. And we're facing now what and where and how we will move on. What new things God is doing for us in this congregation. And so the master plan and the master's plan will go hand in hand. And if you don't need to go to that, you can come to my Advent Bible study and we'll find out why Advent is important, so forth and so on. Two great choices. But Jesus says, you will be persecuted. And clergy were, congregations too. Remember one young man running for a vestry who said, if I'm elected, we'll get rid of the mask. Hey, you idiot. Well, he wasn't elected. He didn't run. But God is constantly moving us forward. And Jesus says, don't worry about what you're going to say. And most of us clergy did worry about what we're going to say. We didn't want to offend anyone. We wanted to try to make sure that we kept you all together as a community of faith. And we wanted to rejoice you being able to come back and break bread, even if we had mask or no mask or this or that or no chalice or now with chalice and this and that. Trying to constantly move on to be able to break bread together to restore back what we had and what we missed. And to move on. And what's fascinating, Jesus says, don't worry about what you say. I will speak. You ever met a couple or you ever been married long enough or in relationship enough that your spouse or your significant other can complete your sentences? Right? And that's what Jesus is talking about. The intimacy that we share as brothers and sisters in Christ, that we share with our Lord, He begins the conversation and we can finish it. Or we begin it and He finishes. How is that possible? Well, it goes back to the collect. It goes back to today's collect. Bless the Lord who has caused all Holy Scripture to be written for our learning. May we learn, mark, read, and we digest them. Used to be in the old book, the second Sunday of Advent. Now they moved it to we kind of miss it, the second Sunday of Advent. And yes, I'm one of those old curmudgeons who liked it the way things were. So I preach to myself. Jesus said, when the devil said to him in the temptation, he says, command these stones to become bread. What did he say? Man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeded from the mouth of God. And we pray in our Lord's Prayer, give us this day our daily bread. And we're not talking about manna. We're talking about the Word. As we move forward into this new liturgical season, we need to feast on that Word, that you and I become biblically literate. That as God moves us through this age and these various things that happen to us, we can make sense of what God is doing and how God is constantly with us. Even though it all disappears, I am with you. Even though it looks like where is God in all this, God is present. And I know that because of what Scripture tells us. And what we hear Sunday after Sunday after Sunday, either in lesson or in liturgy or in hymn or in song, God moves us from one place to another, and not one of us will be lost unless we get our noses bent and decide not to go. God constantly, the invitation to draw closer, to draw nearer, to one another and to the Lord is constantly there. Don't worry about what you will say. I will speak through you to bring those who have not heard of you to you. That's the promise of God, that intimacy. And for that, we rejoice. Amen.
Please stand as we affirm our faith of the night. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe
in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only
Son of God,
eternally
begotten of the Father,
God from
God,
light
from light,
true God
from true God,
God
from
God,
not made,
of one
being the
Father,
through him all things were made.
For us
and for our salvation,
he came
down
from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit,
he came
incarnate
from the Virgin Mary,
and
was made man.
For our
sake,
he was
crucified
in the
Pontius
Pilate.
He
suffered
death and
was
buried.
On the third
day,
he rose
again.
According
to
the Scriptures,
he
ascended into
heaven,
and is
seated
at the
right
hand of the
Father.
He will come
again
in glory
to
judge
the living
and the
dead,
and
his
kingdom
will
have
no
end. We believe
in the
Holy
Spirit,
the Lord,
the giver
of
life,
who
proceeds
from
the Father
and
the
Son.
With
the Father
and the
Son,
he is
worshipped
and glorified.
He has
spoken
to the
prophets.
We believe
in
one
holy
Catholic
apostolic
church.
We
acknowledge
the
baptism
of the
forgiveness
of sins.
We look for
the
resurrection
of the dead
and the life
of the world
to come.
Amen.
The prayers of the people can be found on page 387 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us open our hearts to God. Please kneel as you are able. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church. Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let the light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your
heavenly. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
We pray for all in our congregation who are grieving and in need of care, as well as those who provide care to the grieving and those in need, especially our Stephen ministers. Please join me in lifting up to God those who have asked for our prayers, especially Mary Lee Allen,
Andy Anderson,
Stephen
Scott Ellett. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the congregations and clergy of Good Shepherd in Bluemont, St. Andrew's in Burke, and St. Peter's Oak Grove in Colonial Beach. We ask for your blessings on the birth of Nolan George Elgin, son of Laura and Frank Elgin Jr., and brother of Frank Elgin III, who was born recently. We ask for your blessing on the marriage of Brenna Majet, daughter of Sue and Kurt Majet, and Karsten DeWolf, son of Lisa and Theo DeWolf, who were married here yesterday. We give thanks for the lives and ministries of all who celebrate their birthdays this week, and especially those who celebrate their birthday today: Robert DeWolf, Meredith Lawton, Ralph Rehard, and Ellie Tate. In assurance and hope of the resurrection to eternal life, we remember David Barnett, Anne Garreau, and Wallace C., who died recently, and Emma Conquest Wheat, James Clifton Wheat, Mr. and Mrs. Edwin Parker Conquest, James Clifton Wheat Jr., and Wiley Hardy Wheat, in whose memory the flowers at the altar are given. We offer our prayers and thanks this week to our nation's veterans and continue to hold up in prayer all those who are serving in our armed forces. Almighty God, we commend to your gracious care and keeping all the men and women of our armed forces at home and abroad. Defend them day by day with your heavenly grace. Strengthen them in their trials and temptations. Give them courage to face the perils which beset them, and grant them a sense of your abiding presence wherever they may be. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help, for you are gracious. O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Let us now confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Please stand. Peace with the Lord be always with you. Part of our service are acolyte positions, so if any acolytes are here or available, if they can come forward at this time, even if you're acolyting today, you can come on down. We've got to give you, make you official call. Katie, we need to round up all the acolytes. All right, everybody come on down. Down at the bottom. Great. We are all baptized by one Spirit into one body. We're given gifts for a variety of ministries for the common good. Today we gather here at St. James' to commission these youth in the name of God and of this congregation to the acolyte ministry for which they have been called. Each acolyte here has been trained for service, receives an Episcopal acolyte pin as a sign of their commitment and preparedness for this ministry. Acolytes, I'm going to ask you a question to which the response is, "We will." All right, you're with me. Good. Will you faithfully and reverently execute the duties of your ministry to the honor of God and the benefit of this congregation? Signify by saying, "We will." Let's try one more time. Signify by saying, "We will." Work on that. Let us pray. Gracious Father, bless the acolytes of your church that they may also serve before your earthly altar in reverence and holiness, that they may obtain with all your saints and angels the joy of serving you and worshiping you before your heavenly altar. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and everybody says,
Amen.
All right, turn around, everybody, and I present to you our acolytes at St. James's. We do have more acolytes, okay? Don't worry. This is the 9 o'clock acolyte. All right, thank you all very much. If you are a guest or visitor at St. James's, we're awfully happy to see you today. We're so glad to have you with us. As was mentioned in the prayers, this is Veterans Day, Friday, I believe. And at all the church services, I always like to take an opportunity to recognize all of our veterans and to give thanks for them as well. So if you were a veteran, have served, or did serve in our armed forces, please stand up for just a minute so we may recognize you. Some very important announcements. As was mentioned, I know how much Episcopalians love a new thing. But we do have our master plan presentation today at 10:15 in Valentine Hall with our architects from Glave and Holmes. This was a process we originally started in 2020 and obviously had to put on hold, but we're back working hard. We've had a great committee working on this. But please do come over. We need everyone's input and support for this to go forward so that it can be the master's plan. Exactly. I like that, master's plan. I'm going to think about that. The taste is this Wednesday, okay? The taste is this Wednesday. This year we didn't do pre-orders, so you have to come out. But that will be here at St. James's over in Valentine Hall beginning at 5 o'clock Wednesday. So take note of that. The taste for St. James is this Wednesday. Today is the second Sunday of our Thanksgiving food drive for Feed More. You can get bags in the back of the narthex. Please grab those as well and get them back to us by Thanksgiving Day. We have a wonderful offering tonight of Evensong, 5 o'clock here in the sanctuary. It's a tradition that goes back many centuries and is a certain contribution to the Christian tradition from the Anglican and Episcopal side of things. So please come out for Evensong at 5. We also have a very special concert this week. Our own parishioner Lisa Niemeyer is giving her senior recital tomorrow night at 7 o'clock here in the sanctuary, so come out for that. And there are lots of wonderful musical offerings, so please do look at the musical calendar and see the things that are coming up. Vestry nominations are still going forward. The deadline's fast approaching, so get your nominations in. Also, just a reminder, Cynthia and I will be opening up our house again for a Christmas party December 11th, so just to save the date at this time. But we're looking forward to kicking off the Christmas season and seeing everybody there. Again, I'd like to say the only thing missing here at St. James's is you, so please do get involved. Read your e-chimes carefully, and we'll look forward to seeing you wherever we may be in the coming weeks. Walk in love as Christ loved us, gave himself for us an offering and a sacrifice to God.
At this time, any children who would want an up-close view of communion are welcome to come forward at this time.
Our service continues now with the great thanksgiving of Eucharistic Prayer B, found in your worship bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks.
It is right to do a joyful thing always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death in the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Blessed James, our patron, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat in peace. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father,
you have graciously accepted us
as living
members of your Son and our Savior Jesus Christ.
You have fed us with spiritual food, sacrament of the body and blood.
Send us now into the world of peace,
and grant
us strength and courage
to love
and serve you
with gladness
and singleness of heart.
Through Christ our Lord. Peace of God, which passes all understanding, your hearts and minds and knowledge of God, and of his Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you, remain with you now and always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.